Good morning, students. How are you? Well, today we are going to do work in the grammar book. So take out the grammar book quickly and open the page number 74. There you may see a new unit, unit 15. The title is Tasty Treats. Here we will learn how to make mini pizzas. And for mini pizzas, we may need some ingredients also. And there are 5 steps to make a mini pizza. So let's see which ingredients we may need. We need tomato, cheese, dough, olive oil, oregano, and olives. We need 6 ingredients to make a mini pizza. Now let's read what to do with them. So we need 8 tomatoes and we have to cut them into slices, and we need 4 cups of grated cheese, 1 can of chopped tomatoes. First we will cut 8 tomatoes into the slices, then we will rub cheese on a grater, and of course we need some dough. 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 1 teaspoon of oregano, and some olives. So these are the ingredients that we may need when we make a mini pizza. And let's read the recipe now. The first step is, put a piece of baking paper on a baking tray. So first of all, we will put a baking paper on a baking tray. Spread the olive oil on the baking paper. Then we will spread some olive oil on the baking paper. So the second step, cut 2 or 3 rounds of dough. We will cut 2 or 3 rounds of dough and we will put them on the baking paper. And the third step is, we will put some chopped tomatoes on each round of dough. After that, the next step is, we will put a slice of tomato, some cheese, a little oregano, and a few olives on each round. On each round of what? On each round of dough. And the last step is that we will cook this mini pizza in the oven for 10 minutes only. Fine. And after the 10 minutes, our delicious mini pizza is ready to eat. On the same page, you may see exercise B. There is a chart. One column is for the count nouns and the other is non-count nouns. So before doing the exercise, we must know that what is the count noun and what is the non-count noun. I am reading definition of count nouns. Count noun are individual people, places, animals, and things that can be counted. So it means count nouns are those people, animals, things, and places that can be easily counted, means we can count them. Simple as that. If we see many buildings in a colony, fine. So if we can count them, that are count nouns. And we if we see there are many people on the road and we are able to count them, which means they are count nouns. If we see there are the bundle of the books on the table and we are still able to count them, so which means they are count nouns. So basically, count nouns are those things, person, places, or things that we can easily count. And we use numbers to count them. Numbers means 12 color pencils, 24 books, or we can say like 50 people. So we use number to count them, and these nouns have both singular and plural form. Means I can say there is one laptop on the desk, or I can say there are two laptops on the desk. So when I say one laptop, so it's the singular form, and when I said two laptops, it's the plural form. So count noun have both of the forms, singular and the plural. For example, there are five hotels in a row. So five hotels shows the plural form. And then the next example, your book is on the dining table, shows that the singular form. So count nouns have the both of the forms. We use how many with the plural count noun. Let's suppose we are talking about more than one person, more than one place, more than one thing, more than one animal, and we can also count them without any hesitation. So that noun is plural count noun. We call it plural count noun. Now whenever we talk about plural count noun, we use how many with it. So when we ask question, fine, like how many places have you visited, how many books are on the table, how many pencils are in your hands, so we use how many with count noun. And count nouns are those nouns that can be counted. We can easily count them. And the plural count noun is that more than one. And with the plural count noun, what we use? We use how many. And why we use how many? Whenever we ask question. Fine, understood. Let's read the example. How many candles are on the birthday cake? Example 2. How many color pencils are in your hands? Now, can we count candles on the cake? Of course, yes. Or if you have color pencils in your hand, can you count them? Again, of course, yes. Now, if you are having more than one pencil, it means you have the plural form of the noun. And if you can count them, so it's the count noun. Now, what is the non-count noun? Non-count nouns are those people, places, animals, and things that cannot be counted. So it's the opposite of the count nouns. Here, we cannot count places, people, animals, and things. We are not able to count them, but we use counters to quantify them. But whenever we need to count them, we may need some help of counters. Let's suppose, well, we are not able to count the milk, isn't it? Because there are a lot of drops in 1 liter milk. So here we may need help of a counter, and that counter is 1 liter bottle of milk. So remember, non-count nouns are those nouns that cannot be counted, but yes, we can count them with the help of the counters. Fine. And these nouns are only in singular form. In the count noun, we were having two forms, singular and the plural, but with the matter of the non-count nouns, we just have one form, that is the singular. I repeat, a lot of drops together make 1 liter of the milk, but that a lot of drops are in only one bottle of the milk. There is only one bottle, which means there is only one form, singular form, in the non-count nouns. So let's read the example now. there is no more water in the pond. Again, if there is a pond, only one pond, fine. And there is a lot of the water in the pond. Can we count all the drops? No, we cannot count. So, water is the non-count noun and it is in the pond and pond is one. So, it's the singular form. Example 2. My mother uses real butter in the cake she bakes. So, butter is like cream. Can we count cream? Like how we can count cream? We cannot count the cream. So, non-count are those nouns that cannot be count. Okay. Another thing is that whenever we ask question for the non-count, for the count noun, whenever we were asking question, we were using how many. But in the non-count nouns, if we ask question, so we start our question like how much. Fine. And in this, we talk about the large amount of the things and that cannot be counted. But we may have some counters to count them. And it refers the whole quantity, which means we talk about the whole quantity. Like I gave you example, 1 liter of the milk. So we were talking about the whole quantity, that how much milk was there. It was the 1 liter of the milk. So we talk about the large amount of something and we talk about the whole quantity. And again, I repeat that non-count nouns does not have the plural form. It has only one form, one singular form. So let's come to the exercise now on the page 74, exercise B. Again, I repeat that there is a chart of count nouns and non-count noun. So I hope the concept is clear to you now and we can be able to solve the exercise. What we have to do, we have to reread the reading again, the whole recipe, and we have to find out the count nouns and the non-count nouns. Then we have to write them into the correct column. So start writing count nouns. Number 1, olives. Number 2, tomatoes. Number 3, pizza. These all are the count nouns. Now start writing non-count nouns. Now start writing the non-count nouns. Number 1, olive oil. Number 2, dog, D-O-U-G-H. Number 3, cheese. Number 4, baking paper. So these all are the non-count nouns. Now move to the page 75, exercise B. So what we have to do, we have to write C in the blank if we think that we can count this noun, and we will write N if we think that this noun cannot be count. So in simple words, we will write C for the count noun and we will write N for the non-count noun. So the number 1 is paper. We cannot count paper, so write N in the first blank. Number 2, cheese. Again, we cannot count cheese, but we can count with the help of the counter, so it's the non-count noun. So write down N in blank 2. Number 3, tomato. Yes, we can count tomato, so write C in the third blank. Number 4, pizza. Yes, we can count pizza no matter how many they are, so write down C in the fourth blank. Number 5, water. We cannot count water, so N is in the number fifth blank. 6, juice. Again, non-count, write down N in the 6th blank. Then 7, lemon. Yes, we can count lemon. So write C in the blank number 7. Number 8, honey. We cannot count honey, so write N in the blank 8. Number 9, bread. We can count bread, so write C. Number 10, cookie. Yes, we can count cookie, so write C in the blank 10. 11, milk. We cannot count milk, so write N in the blank 11. Number 12, carrot. Yes, we can count them, so write down C in the 12 blank. So this is the list of the count and non-count nouns. And if you see in your surroundings, you can also find so many count and so many non-count nouns as well. So this is all for today. Have a good day. Allah Hafiz.